From Faith Baptist Church, this is Power Surge. Now your speaker, Jim Kane.
I'm reading today from Luke chapter 1 and verse 30 is where I'm going to start. If you are following along in Scripture, I'm going to read out of Matthew chapter 1, Luke chapter 1, Luke chapter 2. So while I'm giving those that are following along in Scripture a moment to find it, in Matthew 1 and Luke 1 and Luke 2, let me encourage those that are watching by video and or listening on the radio. We would love to have you visit us at Faith. We meet on Sunday mornings at 10:30 a.m. here at Faith. And if you want more information, you want to contact us, send us your prayer request, if you'll simply look in the corner of the screen down there from time to time, and it will tell you, but I will tell you now, it's faithbaptistlinden.com. That's faithbaptistlinden.com. We would sure love to have you visit us if you don't have a church home, and we would love for you to contact us. The title of the message today is Fear Not, and I tell you that up front before I read several verses of Scripture. Fear Not. Quite a different title for a Christmas message. We're here in the Christmas season. So the title of the message here is Fear Not. Luke chapter 1, and I'm going to start reading at verse 30. An angel said unto her, that's being Mary, Fear not. Remember, that's the title of the message. Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. Now I want to go forward to Luke chapter 2, and we'll go to verse number 8 is where we are beginning in Luke chapter 2. The following chapter, Luke chapter 2, verse 8. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them. And they were afraid. And the angel said unto them, here's the title of the message again, Fear not. For behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. Verse 13, and suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them to heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. I'm going to go all the way back now to Matthew chapter 1. What I read to you about the birth of Christ already was Luke's account, Luke's version of the birth. In Matthew chapter 1, I'm going to begin reading in verse 18 and talk a little bit about Matthew's perspective here, if you will. Matthew had a perspective that is very similar, but as in all the Gospels, they heard and saw things or wrote about it a little differently. Matthew 1, verse 18. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise, when, as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. But while he thought on these things, Behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David. Here's the title of the message again. Fear not to take unto thee Mary, thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not until she had brought forth her son, and called his name Jesus. I'm going to go back to Luke, and in Luke Luke chapter 1 again, I'm going to read two verses that also has fear not in it, but it had a little bit different connotation, and it turned out a little bit different. In Luke chapter 1, let me start here with verse 12 and talk a little bit about a different scenario than what Mary did and how she responded and how Joseph did and how he responded. Zacharias, verse 12, Luke 1, verse 12. And when Zacharias saw him, he was troubled and fear fell upon him. Verse 13, but the angel of the Lord said to him, title of the message again, fear not, Zacharias, for thy prayer is heard, and thy wife Elizabeth shall bear thee a son, and thou shalt call his name John. Let us pray. Father, I thank you for your word today. A lot of verses, a lot of scripture, but it is so powerful to recount how you clothed yourself in flesh and came into this world. And at this season and this time, we celebrate your birth. We celebrate you, God manifested in the flesh, coming down so you could live and experience and be tempted and go through life in the ways that we are as humans. I thank you for your blessings, and I pray that you would bless us for the next few moments. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. The title of the message is Fear Not. So as I talk about that in a Christian message, which is a little bit different here, I want to ask you this. What is your reaction when Jesus says to you, fear not? When he speaks to you in that still, small, quiet voice that we know when he speaks and we know it's him. Sometimes we don't like what he's saying. But he whispers to us, or he tells us in our spirit boldly, fear not. My question to you is, do you chill when he says fear not? Or do you freak out a little bit? And I want to look at the scriptures that I read. I read about Mary, and when Gabriel the angel showed up to Mary, here's what Mary did. She trusted. Do you trust him when he comes to you and says, fear not? Oh, Mary probably had some confusion. And according to the word, maybe she didn't understand and she didn't get it, but here's what I know, and how she responded is Mary sang a song. And Mary said, my soul doth magnify the Lord. When the angel told her to fear not, she said, my soul, I'm going to trust. My soul doth magnify the Lord. Let me just slip ahead here into the message right here and say to some of you in this particular time and season, maybe you're lonely, maybe it could have been a rough year for you, maybe, there's a bunch of maybes in our lives. But I say to you this morning, as we share this Christmas message, fear not. Fear not and do what Mary did when the angel brought her some very confusing news. And she said, my soul doth magnify the Lord. I feel like I could stop this message right now. And if you would just walk out, and every time you had that confusion or that rattledness that comes along with things in life, and you're told to fear not, I wish you would just say those words and sing that song, my soul doth magnify the Lord. Now the latter scripture that I read, Zacharias here, he wasn't quite as trusting. He got pretty rattled a little bit. As a matter of fact, he got so rattled that he didn't even believe the angel when the angel Gabriel told him that his wife Elizabeth was going to bring forth a son, John the Baptist. He was rattled. And because he was rattled and he didn't go down the path that Mary went and trust the Lord and say, my soul does magnify the Lord, Zacharias did not believe. Pushed back a little bit. And because of that, he freaked out. And when he freaked out, he was stricken dumb. He could not speak because he did not believe and he did not trust. I also read to you in the Christmas story in the two Gospels of Matthew and Luke, I read to you about the shepherds and their response and what they did and what they said and how they did it. They got excited. They, unlike Zacharias, they believed. When they were told, fear not, and Gabriel said, you know, believe my words, they said, let's go to town. Let's go see this Savior. Let's go see this Jesus. Now, here's the big one that I think really rattles probably would rattle probably a lot of us. Joseph's response. I read to you in the Christmas story about Joseph and how in a dream the angel came to him. But I want you to understand, remember the question was, when the Lord tells you to fear not, do you freak out or do you chill? Mary chilled and said, my soul doth magnify the Lord. The shepherds chilled and got excited and said, let's go to town. Zacharias did not chill. He freaked out. And he paid some consequences for that. Joseph, once again, he took the chill route, as did the shepherds and Mary. Joseph didn't hesitate. He got up from that dream and he decided to finish. The wedding process was already started. They already had their license. And he decided to finish the wedding process. All through Scripture, all through this holy book right here, Scripture teaches us to fear not. Isaiah says it like this, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. Once again, fear not. The phrase fear not, there's a lot of debate on exactly how many times it's in there. I've heard lower numbers and I've heard higher numbers. But fear not, the bottom line is in this book right here many, many, many times. Now this is my opinion right now. This is not, I don't have scripture for what I'm going to say right now. I believe the word fear not is used possibly hundreds of times in Scripture, simply because the Lord knows that the enemy, that Satan uses fear to decrease our hope and limit our victories. So the Lord, all through Scripture, in the Old Testament and in the New Testament, he uses fear not. In a past Sunday school lesson, I am reminded that we had here at Faith, I am reminded that we are to have a healthy and respectful fear of God. But we're not supposed to walk around cowardly. Mary and Joseph and the shepherds, they chilled out when they were told, fear not. They did not walk around cowardly, but they had that healthy and that respectful fear of the Lord. It's kind of like the ocean. It's a wonderful place. My family loves to go to the beach. We love the Gulf and the ocean. We love it, we love it, we love it, we love it. But we also have a healthy respect. We also have a healthy fear. And when they're advertising and saying there are undercurrents out there that are pretty strong, we're going to stay either out of the water or a little closer to the beach. In the Christmas story, the people were told to fear not. So let me encourage you today, fear not. No matter what kind of year you've had, no matter what this Christmas season is like for you, no matter what it brings to you, don't let fear make a decision for you. Fear not. I like to teach people and encourage people to be able to relax, to enjoy the scripture that says fear not, simply because it's in there multiple times. Now, I don't know exactly when Christmas was. I'm not going to argue with it. I'm not a theologian. I'm not a Bible scholar, and I do know that most theologians and Bible scholars, about the only thing they agree on when Christmas was, is that it wasn't December the 25th. I don't care. I think we should set aside. I think it's wonderful we've set December the 25th aside to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. I really don't care, but here's what I do know. Fear not, because a Savior was born. I read it to you in Scripture. A Savior was born of a virgin, and Jesus came into this world to save us from our sins. He came into this world to deliver us. He came into this world to heal us, and he sacrificed his life later on. 33 years later, he sacrificed his life for you and for me. Fear not. Mark Lowry wrote a song several years ago. It's called Mary, Did You Know? I jotted some of the words down. It says, Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child, Mary, that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to the blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know? Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, in closing this message out, in this season, no matter where you are, you're on cloud 9 today, cloud 12, cloud 2. Wherever you are, listen to what I'm saying today in this Christmas season message. Fear not, because God has it all in control. And God is able to take care of us. He robed himself in flesh. And he came down and he was born of the Virgin Mary, conceived by the Holy Ghost. And he did that to deliver you, to save you, to heal you, and to help you in everything that you face. But most of all, to save your soul. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your word. Oh, I thank you for the Christmas story. I'm not sure why I don't generally read it more than once a year, but it's just so powerful to look back and see what Zacharias went through and how he responded. And yet Joseph and Mary and the shepherds responded and trusted you. That's what I want us to do today. Father, help me. Help those that are listening and those that are watching. Help us to respond to you today when you say, fear not, and trust you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
This has been Power Surge with Speaker Jim Cain of Faith Baptist Church. For more information about this ministry, visit us online at faithbaptistlinden.com or visit us in person Sunday mornings at 10:30 a.m.